I mean, this is a video I'd been wanting to make for years, but up until this point, we either had super hot, dedicated GPU with an H-series processor, or just a mobile processor with very little performance and no dedicated GPU. And this evolution in technology is what's put us in a place where we now have more decisions, which is great, but also complicates the buying process. Now, I have before me two laptops with mobile processors. However, one of these laptops comes with a dedicated GPU, and the other just comes with the simple integrated graphics that are already on board these mobile processors today. Now, the interesting thing is that Photoshop actually does utilize a GPU, but maybe not the GPU that you would think of. And so we'll get into that later in the video. So I want to make sure you hang on for that. But this laptop is answering the question that if you're a creative professional, do you need a dedicated GPU? And we're going to answer that question today for multiple use cases, whether it be 3D modeling, using After Effects for motion design, video editing, Photoshop, graphic design work, whatever it might be. Let's get right into it. First and foremost, let's understand what we're working with here. We have two laptops before me, both with the i7-1195G7. Now, these are mobile processors with 4 cores and 8 threads. They both have a low TDP, which means the power consumption that they are utilizing to run the laptop is lower compared to, say, something like an 8-series processor, which has a very high TDP. It's all very technical. You don't need to understand it necessarily for this video, but if you want to, I've made other videos about that, and you can check out my channel for those videos. But all that to say, these processors consume a low amount of power, produce a low amount of heat, and don't make a lot of noise, which makes them very beneficial for on-the-go creators like graphic designers, artists, photographers, and even video editors that want a cool and quiet laptop. Now, where this video takes a twist is we finally have a laptop that has a mobile processor and a dedicated GPU. For years, we've only had laptops that have come with 8-series processors and dedicated GPUs. What that meant was they were loud, they had very poor battery life, and they were thermal heat junkies. They just produced a ton of heat. And for years, I've been asking brands, can you produce a mobile processor with a dedicated GPU? And finally, we have that before us. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is Photoshop. So this would help graphic designers, artists, and photographers make their buying decision. Keep in mind, Photoshop actually does require a GPU to run some of the tasks and features that are inside of Photoshop. But you can utilize an integrated GPU inside of Photoshop, say inside of the i7-1195G7. You don't technically need a dedicated GPU to run Photoshop. But keep in mind that it does utilize GPU functionality. So when you have a dedicated GPU, you're going to get more performance in those specific tasks. And you can see those tasks coming up on the screen now. It's a number of tasks that you may or may not use on a day-to-day basis. So go ahead, look at this list and reference your daily workflow. If it matches up, then a dedicated GPU might be beneficial to you. Now, in regards to the scores of these two laptops, the MSI Summit E16 scores an 800 in the Photoshop Puget Systems benchmark, whereas the Lenovo Yoga 9i scores a 674. So that dedicated GPU actually takes those tasks that are labor-intensive for a GPU and improves upon them with the dedicated GPU. The performance difference is found in those specific tasks, not Photoshop in general. So I hope that helps with the understanding of a buying decision in regards to Photoshop. The specific tasks listed previously require a GPU, but not a dedicated GPU. The dedicated GPU will just give you slightly more performance. Now, in regards to video editing, the dedicated GPU is actually very important because there's a lot of processes that the CPU pushes onto the GPU, which allows them to run smoother, faster, and more efficient, which ultimately gives you a better workflow and allows you to create faster. Place we're going to see this the most is within the export times and the playback. As you can see, in regards to 4K playback on the Lenovo Yoga 9i, it dropped 12,000 frames out of the 16,177 in the project, which basically was a very jumpy, unstable editing experience. However, with the dedicated GPU, the RTX 3050 in the MSI laptop, we only saw 381 drop frames, which is basically unnoticeable throughout the edit. Now, in regards to export times, we did see faster export times out of the MSI laptop, so that will save you time on the export. Now, keep in mind, if you want to edit 6K, something like 6K B-RAW footage, the RTX 3050 dropped about 8,000 frames matched with the i7-1195G7. Over on the Lenovo Yoga 9i, it dropped nearly every single frame. It was around 15,000 drop frames. So it's literally unusable in regards to 6K B-RAW. So you could get away with 6K video editing on this laptop. It just will not be a very smooth experience. I recommend going with an 8-series processor to get a much much smoother experience for 6K video editing. Now, in regards to DaVinci Resolve, because these two laptops are Intel laptops, and I've seen Intel laptops have poor export times out of DaVinci Resolve, I would honestly not recommend either of these laptops for DaVinci Resolve. I would go with a Ryzen processor, or I would go with an Apple laptop with the new Apple M1 silicon. I think that would be a much better decision. Or go ahead and upgrade to an Intel i7 H series processor or i9 H series processor. I would not go for mobile CPUs inside of DaVinci Resolve. Now, in regards to After Effects, I was actually quite surprised that the mobile processor did so well in After Effects, scoring a 471, which is not earth-shattering. A good score to me is around the 700 mark, but it still was very suitable. Now, if you add the RTX 3050 to that processor, like we do with the MSI here, it gets you up to about a 596, which is good. It's a good score, but like I said, I like to see my laptops around the 700s for a very smooth After Effects experience. Now, switching over to 3D modeling and architecture, the RTX 3050 definitely makes this laptop capable of 3D modeling. However, I would not say it is my go-to recommendation for 3D modeling whatsoever. However, if it's something you may be considering doing on occasion, it would be a good pick. If you had to decide between these two laptops for 3D modeling, it's not even a question. You need the dedicated GPU for 3D modeling to get the performance that you need. Now, keep in mind, these laptops are about $350 in difference. So if you're somebody who has that extra cash and wants to make sure they're future-proofing their laptop in their creative profession, then I would definitely recommend going with the dedicated GPU over the non-dedicated GPU unit. I really enjoyed the MSI E16. It's one of the only laptops that I've seen on the market currently that has a mobile processor and a dedicated GPU. Now, the only other one that I've seen as of late is going to be the Acer Swift X that has a U-series processor from Ryzen and a dedicated GPU. Basically the same setup, just Intel versus Ryzen. If you have any questions or comments, definitely comment below. I'd love to know your feedback on this video. Otherwise, links if you want to make a purchase of either of these laptops in the description below. Likes if this video has brought you some value, and subs if you want to miss out on the future uploads. I'll see you here in the next one.